Welcome to my weekly episode of Burlington Spotlight, where I talk to local owners who've been impacted by COVID-19 and how their businesses changed and the challenges around those changes. And today we have a special guest we all know and love is Shannon Guthrie, the owner of A Whole Bunch Flowers in Burlington. Hi, Shannon. Hi. How are you?
Good, thank you. Thank you for having me.
Oh, thank you for joining me today. I really appreciate it because I know you guys have probably been very, very busy these last few weeks getting prepared.
It's been busy.
So you are typically a very busy florist. What was it like before this crisis started for you guys?
So we do about 150 weddings a year, and we have a terrific team here. I know you know a lot of them. Of people who do all kinds of different things, but the weddings are a huge part of our business, as are funerals, parties. We work with the hotels and the restaurants in town. We do the flowers for the Bancroft, the Capitol Grill, a lot with Landana, all the Archer, a lot of local places. So week to week, we were just busy, busy, busy. And for florists, I don't know if you know, but April, May, June is the busiest time of the year. We make something like 60% of our income during those 3 months. And our business is probably about 40% wedding income and then 20 funerals. So that is really a huge part of what we do. And we were hopping along in March. We had just celebrated our 13-year anniversary in Burlington in business, and we had a big promo going. And then, as you know, everything changed.
Right. And so those changes really did impact your business immensely. As disappointing as all those weddings were canceled or postponed, that did impact you as well. And so what were some of the changes that you had to adapt with all of that happening?
Well, the first thing that happened is right before we closed, a wedding was canceled for Sunday on a Thursday night, and we had thousands of dollars of flowers in the shop, and we had like 3 days to clear everything out. You know, we didn't want to throw it away, so we donated a lot of flowers to the nurses at Leahy. We have a connection there who really helped us out, Patty. And the team leapt into action and came up with some great ideas, specials. We gave markdowns. We did porch deliveries of flowers and kits that people could make arrangements with their kids. And we just got everything out the door as fast as we could. And then we were shut down for, gosh, over 2 months. And everyone was at home. And I have a great team that does a great job with social media. So you may have seen people gardening with their kids or where we were taking walks together, social distancing as best we could. So it went along like that, really, until the governor said that florists could open partially for Mother's Day. And then we called back just a few of us. We only have maybe a third of our staff back at this point. We're just bringing people back little by little and sort of easing into it. But we cleaned the whole place and got ready for Mother's Day and did a ton of deliveries and a ton of pickups. And that went really well. We had a really good Mother's Day.
I drove by and I had to drive by two or three times because the lines were outside the door.
Yes.
I think everybody knew through your social media that you did open up for Mother's Day, which was quite a surprise for all of us in town. And I'm really happy to hear that.
And the governor only announced, I think, like the Wednesday before, and Mother's Day was Sunday. So we really had to hop to. It's been a huge year for outdoor plants. Everybody, first of all, shopping outdoors is great. We sometimes have tent sales where people can be outdoors and shop, which really helps. But then also people are home, so they're decorating their homes. They want the hanging baskets. They want the planters for the porch. And we have a great local organic herb grower and local flower growers that have been sending us all kinds of plants. So that's been huge this year. I think everything, we were just saying before, everything's moving outside. People are going to do the cookouts and the outdoor parties this year, and that's how we're going to have our fun.
Shannon, when the governor told you on a Wednesday that you could partially open for Mother's Day,
yeah,
how did you hustle and get all those flowers within a very short period for Mother's Day in preparation of all those people that wanted to buy flowers?
That's a really good question. I had actually kind of gambled ahead a little bit that we would have some kind of a reprieve. Some florists, it was a little unclear, the rulings with us, because some florists were doing pickups and non-contact deliveries all along, much like the restaurants, even though it wasn't really clear. So we gambled. I had some of the stuff in the pipeline already, and we've worked with the same vendors and growers for so many years. Everybody just really came through for us. I couldn't get everything I wanted, and still to this, you know, still now it's a struggle to get all the flowers and plants we could possibly want. But they really came through, and everything was really fresh and great, because on the grower end too, they've had to throw out a lot of flowers and plants, and they were so happy to have us come back and grab all these great things.
That's wonderful. That really served a great purpose for everybody. And so during the crisis, we had funerals were still taking place, even though they were more private and just small groups. So were you delivering flowers to the funeral homes, and were you able to get the flowers during the
Right. Well, the first thing that happened, our vendors shut down. The two main suppliers we used shut down right away. And so that was when we made the decision to close, do a full close, because we could have sort of scavenged around, but we didn't want to rely on that. So during the actual shutdown, we weren't delivering at all. We weren't here at all. Now that we're open, people are doing funerals. They're coming back a little bit, like in the past few weeks between Mother's Day and now we've been delivering and stuff. Smaller funerals are going to be the thing. Smaller weddings, people who might have ordered a big casket piece might now just want a hand-tied bouquet because they're doing a graveside service. And then the weddings too, a lot of people are moving the big parties to next year or to the winter or the fall for sure.
Yeah.
But people are doing the small backyard weddings right now. And the feedback we're getting from our brides is that they love their small backyard wedding, that it's so much more intimate and they're actually kind of embracing it. It's sort of becoming a new trend that we're seeing, is that people are really wanting to do that and enjoy it. And they figure, okay, next year we'll have a big party, but right now we'll have the family and the close people, and that's how it's going to go.
And so with regard to the weddings, next year there's going to be everybody who had to postpone and cancel this year are obviously going to do it next year. Now, what does that mean for you? Because people have to order their flowers ahead of time, and you're probably going to get double whammy next year.
Because 2020 was already the huge year. Everyone wanted to get married in 2020 because what a cool year, what a cool name it was before we knew what was going to happen. So this was a huge wedding year for all us florists already. So now all of those are moving to next year. We already had some on the books. And we want to honor any bride or groom who has to move to next year. We're going to honor their date, whatever they get, because, it's been such a tough year. We don't want anybody to have to struggle. So, next year is going to be a huge wedding year. But I'll tell you, my team loves weddings. They love that. They're all about it. They're like, and by then everybody will be back and we'll just pull together and we'll get it done.
And what do you recommend, and what's your advice to these new brides out there now that are planning their weddings of next year? Should they be thinking about flowers now and booking them now with you ahead of time? How far
Definitely.
In advance?
Yeah, it's really good to book early, especially for any of the busy month. The spring and fall are the biggest times. And in those times, we always get sold out. And this year we may sell out, well in advance, because a lot of our brides and grooms are just moving to next year already. So the earlier people get in, the better. And then you can make changes all along, but it's, it's a good idea to plan early.
That's good advice for all you brides to be out there, book now ahead of time.
Yeah.
That's good advice. So now that you are in phase two, what we're in. So you've just officially opened for the public on Monday. So what does that look like for you now?
Right. So, in terms of our store it's small, but it actually has a pretty good layout for social distancing because we have two doors and there's sort of a flow through pattern. So what we've done is actually a friend of mine that I went to high school with wanted to do something for the store, and she bought us two cashier shields to have up. So we've had those in place since Mother's Day. We put them up right away. We clean really well every night. Everybody wears a mask. The customers wear a mask. If somebody doesn't have one, we have them for them that we can give. But people have been great. I think people around here at least are very in the groove with the social distancing now. Like, they know not to get right next to somebody. And we have tape on the floor, to show the distancing, but people don't really need it. They've been very considerate. And like I said, the outdoor thing has been huge. If we anticipate a big weekend, we'll put up the outdoor tent, put some bunches out there, and have one of our great kids, which your daughter used to be one of before she went to college, go out and wait on people and help them get plants down and stuff. And we love it. I love the whole outdoor piece. It's just been great.
Yes. Well, whenever anyone's around flowers, it just cheers us up with all the smells, the frequencies and the colors. I just love flowers myself. So
yes. And I love the being outside, because inside I feel like I'm always bleaching things and cleaning and stuff. I got bleach on my shirt last week because we just scrub everything down, all the tools, all the counters and stuff at night. I think most of the businesses around here are so great. I'm sure everybody's doing the same things.
It's a lot of extra work, obviously, for you and your staff to keep everybody yourself safe as well as your customers. Yeah. So we completely get it. And we as a community are getting used to it. It's becoming now second nature to wear masks. So Shannon, What are your hours? Are you still
Monday? It's a little bit gone week by week. I'm trying to post it every Monday. So this week, being the first week, we did 9 to 5 Monday through Saturday and 8 to 2 on Sunday. These are shorter hours than we used to have. We think we'll gradually build back to our longer hours, especially as we bring more staff back. It's partly the staffing and partly the people just aren't quite, we aren't around as much. We don't have as much work with the lack of weddings and the hotels and everything. So there's not as much to do in the evening while you wait for customers to come in. So we're kind of trying to spread it. But I think, certainly by the fall, we'll be back to our full hours. I'm not sure what we'll do this summer. We'll have to see how it goes. If customers are wanting to come in later in the evening as people get back to work, if they're wanting to come in after work, we'll certainly expand our hours.
And you guys are so spectacular on social media between Instagram and Facebook, and people should follow you on a whole bunch of flowers. You not only post beautiful flowers, but you also send lots of very good updates with what you do at the store. And we all love and follow you for that.
Thank you. We have my designers here are both terrific. If they make something new or bridal work, they're so happy to take pictures of it and post it. Lindsay was doing that from home a lot, and Karen was making things here and sending it to Lindsay so she could do it. So it's a lot of teamwork.
We all know that everybody in your store, especially when we go in, they all love what they do, and you can tell by when you
walk. Oh, thank you. We really do.
You look, peek behind all those flowers, and you see them back there working very hard. And I always give them a smile when I'm there because you can tell they love what they do.
So, I hope so.
They do, and you can tell. So, Shannon, is there anything that you would want to share with people watching this about your store, about the business, about your staff? Is there anything you want to share with us?
Yeah, I would say the things that are coming up for us are, I had an idea that when this is over, people are, or even as it starts to improve as it is now, the COVID, that people are going to want sort of something new. So we created a new line called Renaissance, which you may have seen on our social media. It's on our website. The designers designed it all and named them all with Renaissance names and stuff for fun. And we thought just something new. And it's a little bit of a departure for us because it's a little more natural in style, a little less structured, and a little more the way the trends are going with the higher end work. So look for that on our website for sure. The outdoor product, we're really bringing in some beautiful new things. We've got hibiscus trees. The outdoor, like I said, has been a huge feature this year. We had a huge selection of organic herbs and people really went crazy for them right after Mother's Day. It was like such a thing. I think everybody was planting their garden. And we're just, we're fortunate in that we sort of have our fingers in a lot of pies, so we're able to adapt. We do a lot of different things. We're a walk-in shop, we're a delivery shop, we're a funeral, we're a wedding. So we're kind of focusing on what we can do with what we have right now, like the smaller weddings, the smaller funerals, and then more deliveries for sure. Everything, we've really managed our website so that what you see on there is what we're able to get right now. And then now with the walk-ins back, that's terrific too. The designers just filled up the coolers with all kinds of beautiful stuff. So we're getting gradually back and back, but we're just going to try to run it, lean and mean, and bring back people when we need them and don't if we don't, and try to just have the best customer service. Our kids are back. Like, I was remembering when Alana was here. She was one of the first, but we have, at least a half a dozen young people who with the online learning have much more time. So they're here more to do customer service and make bouquets. And that's really sort of at the heart of our business. That really makes things go.
That's great. I mean, you guys are really good to our local community. You're a big supporter of our community and the young children. You're hiring our kids. You're very supportive to the town of Burlington. And
we love like being that. Part of the community. I mean, that was one thing. We were talking earlier about us being in the mall, right? But it was great getting out of the mall, because when you're in the mall, people think you're part of a big chain or something. Mm-hmm. We never were. We've always been a small, mom and pop type store. So when we moved here next to LaCasha's, now we're part of the community and we're involved, and we love to donate to the events and be part of things. We missed a few of them this spring. I know, like the Relay for Life, but everything was virtual this year, so we didn't get to do our part as much as we would have liked.
But we have a lot to make up for next year. That's for sure. All itchy.
It's gonna be a big year.
There. But I want to I know you're really busy. I know you just opened and you have a lot of people waiting there. I want to just thank you for spending this time with me and sharing what you do. And you can see that the love and the pride you have and your whole staff.
Thank you.
It just just projects out there. So
I wanted to be knocking
on your door and getting my flowers later.
That's right. When you're selling more houses and then taking flowers like you always do.
Yes, yes. Right. My favorite thing. So thanks, Shannon.
Thank you so much, Dorian. It was great to see you.
Thank you. And I'll talk to you soon.
Okay. Take care. Stay well.
You too.